So far, we have prepped the soil, we sowed seeds, we added nutrition. What's next in our journey? The next step is watering the plants. If you recall from our experience growing the tomato, we watered the plants every day, and about fifth day is when we saw the tiny sapling come out of the ground. So why is it important to water the plants? Humans can't go more than a few days without water. Similarly, water is extremely crucial for plants to grow. Starting from the time they germinate till pretty much throughout their lifetime, water is needed for every step in a lot of different processes. In this video, we'll do a deep dive into two reasons why plants need water. We'll look at germination and delivery of nutrition. If you have ever eaten chana sprouts or moong dal sprouts, you have probably already seen the process of germination. If you have seen this being made at home, they basically take the pulses and then soak it in water overnight. And then the pulses are bundled up in a cloth and let it stay out. And after a while, you see these small sprouts come out. Now, why does that happen? How is water important there? To answer those questions, let's look inside the seed. So if you cut open a seed and see inside, you'll see three things. The most of that seed is made of nutrition. And the other part is a tiny embryo. Think of it like the plant that is not born yet. Now, covering these two is an outer shell. When a seed is soaked in water, it starts absorbing this water and the inside starts swelling up. When it grows large enough, it breaks that outer shell. At this point, the embryo, which has that plant, basically the plant can grow out of that broken shell. Now, this is why water is important, because it allows that seed to swell and break and the plant can grow out of that embryo. So initially, the baby plant that just grew can get most of its food from the nutrition that's stored in the seed. But after a while, it runs out and it needs to start making its own food. To do that, it does it through the process of photosynthesis. The leaves need nutrition that we had originally added to the soil for photosynthesis. Now, how do the leaves get this nutrition? Again, here water comes into picture. So the roots can absorb water, and when they do that, they also absorb the nutrition that is dissolved in the water. This water is then transported to various parts of the plant, including leaves, stem, and that's how the leaves finally get the nutrition that we had originally added. So think of water as small delivery trucks that are just going all around the plant. So they play a crucial part in delivery of this nutrition to the plant. Because of these reasons, it's very important to have a steady supply of water for the plants. Now, that word steady is actually very important. Because if you don't have enough water, the plants won't get nutrition. But if you also add too much water, that has some harmful effects. Too much water can lead to water stagnating in the soil, which leads to bacteria and other harmful microbes that can grow. This actually, in some cases, causes the root to rot, which then just breaks that entire water supply system. In other cases, the water stagnation will not let the air to go into the soil, thereby killing microbes and earthworms. At this point, you might be thinking, okay, steady supply is not too hard. I mean, I can just go pour that same amount of water every day. Unfortunately, it's not that easy. If you recall, you yourself might have experienced that in summers, you need a lot more water than you do in winter or rainy season. In the same way, there are a lot of factors that affect how much water a plant needs at any given day. So let's look at a few of these factors. the first thing is seasonal. So in summer, plants need a lot more water because the water is evaporating a lot more from the soil and just from the plants themselves. Whereas in rainy season or in winter, they don't need quite as much water. The other factor is weather conditions. So weather conditions are more short-term things that are happening. So in summer, you can have one particular day which is extremely hot. And similarly, in winter, you can have one particular day that's like extremely cold and it's got like this cold wave. Those are factors that we have to account for. And the farmers have to ensure that even in those extreme cases, a steady supply of water is maintained. The next one is the type of soil. Some soil types have a way to hold on to the water much better than the others. So again, this has to be considered when you're adding water to the plant. You have to make sure that if the soil can hold on to water a lot better, you pour lesser amount of water. The final thing that impacts the amount of water needed is the type of crop itself. The first thing that probably is coming to your mind is cactus. Cactus has evolved in a way that they can survive with very little water. They survive in deserts. So if we have a plant that's like cactus and we pour a lot of water to it, that can also just kill the plant. So these are all different things that a farmer has to keep in mind and make sure that every single day they are giving just the right amount of water to the plant. So let's do a quick summary of what we have learned so far. We looked at two reasons why water is important for the plant. We looked at germination and we also looked at water as a medium for transporting nutrition to the entire plant. We looked at four different factors that can affect the amount of water plant needs in any given day. So we saw that seasonal changes, weather condition, type of soil, and the type of crop itself. So these are four factors that can affect the amount of water needed. So in the next video, we are going to look at different ways the farmers use to ensure that they give this steady supply of water needed by the plants.